Even though we finally got a release date on the new desktop version of Intel Arc, it doesn't mean you can't play with it right now. Well, color us surprised when we checked it out on this laptop. I think we're gonna color you surprised as well. Okay, huge shout out to Intel, Newegg, and MSI for sponsoring this video. On 9/27, we finally got the announcement that Intel Arc was on the horizon with an actual release date and the price for both the flagship Intel Arc A770 and the A750. But believe it or not, Intel Arc is already out and it currently resides, if an Intel Arc can reside, in a laptop. Now today we're gonna be checking it out in the form of an MSI GF series laptop. More specifically, the MSI Thin GF6312001. But for short, we're just gonna call it the Thin GF63. Not the GF63 Thin, but the Thin GF63. Now, given this is a sponsored overview, we're going to be making sure that you have all of the proof you need to see what we saw. Because honestly, we weren't expecting the results we got. In a good way. But I want to make sure that you can make your own informed decision, as because this isn't a review, we're not going to be giving you our opinions. We're just going to be telling you if we got surprised, etc. Okay, so let's start with the basics. The Thin GF63 is a black laptop with a pretty stylish brushed finish. But to be honest, just to give you some fair warning, it is a bit of a fingerprint magnet. Now the word thin in the model number is accurate, as the laptop is only about 0.85 inches thick. So about as thick as a mechanical gaming keyboard, and it weighs roughly 4.1 pounds. It's not as thin as, say, like your Surface Book or like any other ultrabook style laptop, but it is thin for a gaming laptop. For the screen, we've got a 15.6 inch FHD 1920 by 1080p 144 hertz IPS level display. Now the clamshell is pretty sturdy and it has a great feature, especially for laptops in the sub $1,000 range, with the ability to open the laptop one-handed simply by lifting the top. Check it out. There we go. And then again, just open it, no problem, it opens. Believe it or not, this is actually a nice feature to have, especially on some of the thinner laptops. Other laptops, you have to use like two hands to hold the bottom part of the laptop down. And if you have like a, stationary workspace like many gaming laptops do, it's nice to just be able to sit it down with one hand, maybe with a latte, open it up and go ahead and start typing right away, you know, looking all pro as you're like, okay, maybe not. Now for the keyboard on the Thin GF63, well, it's a little bit puzzling. Most 15.6 inch laptops have a full size keyboard with a number pad. The Thin GF63 has an 84 key red backlit anti-ghost keyboard. Now some of the keys are like a bit oddly shaped, like the function keys along with the tilde key, and it's only one function main key on the right side of the space bar. This key also controls things like volume, brightness, and it's used in conjunction with a lot of the arrow keys. So controlling the volume or brightness is a bit of a weird gesture movement. Other than that, the keyboard is what you would expect from a $900 gaming laptop. It works just fine, feels fairly comfortable to type on, and does the job. Now, let's talk about connectivity. Internally, we have Wi-Fi 6, AX201, and Bluetooth 5.2. Externally, we've got three USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. We've got a one USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C port, an HDMI port that supports 4K at 30 hertz. We've also got one mic in, a headphone out. We've got RG45 gigabit LAN jack, which is actually pretty cool. And then we've got the power port, which, you know, honestly, is like placed in the middle of the side. The HDMI is in the back, but we usually like to see all of these things in the back of the laptop, or you know, versus just putting it on the side. But towards the back, it's just like, it doesn't look like almost like a wired octopus. I know it's inexpensive, it's a small gripe, but it's something worth calling out. Okay, so inside is where we have like the real story. We have that 12th gen Core i5-12450H with its 8 total cores. We got 4 P cores and 4 E cores, so it's using Windows 11, which is great. And it's coupled with the new Intel Arc A370M GPU with its 4 gigs of GDDR6 memory. Now, inside we've got a 512 gig NVMe SSD, which you can upgrade, should you want to, with more NVMe storage, as 512 these days isn't quite enough. And there's actually some really good deals, like you can check out with this Western Digital video that I did, on some pretty good, nice, sizable drives that you could replace. Now you do have the option to put a 2.5 inch SSD in, and the laptop comes with the screws and the brackets, which you can see a video of me doing that right here. Now we put a 1 terabyte Team T-Force Vulcan G gaming SSD inside of our laptop, and you can see that. You can see us doing that right here. It was very easy to upgrade, and to be honest, given kind of the budget nature of the laptop, you know, it makes a lot of sense. And to be honest, it's fast enough for you to basically get any load times, etc., with whatever you would throw at it. Now, it's got one stick of Samsung 8GB DDR4 3200MHz RAM that is easily upgradable to 32 gigs with two slots available under the back cover. Now, I'm showing you a picture of us taking this apart and showing and upgrading the RAM. Just thing to remember, once you get all the screws on, make sure that you start from that right-hand side and lift up and then push over once the screws are out, because it'll unclip from the other side. Can be a little tricky, just getting a little bit of a screwdriver. We use the iFixit kit to kind of get it open, and then the back comes off no problem. One thing though that we're gonna let you guys know is for the performance numbers, we're gonna be running both the single 8GB and a 2x8GB configuration to just kind of show you what kind of uplift you get when you upgrade the RAM. And it's only like $50 to upgrade, which is actually pretty cheap. Now, let's talk about the speakers that come with the laptop. It's got Nahimic, I think I'm saying that right, Nahimic 3 high-res audio built in, along with 2x2W Nahimic high-res audio speakers built in as well. The speakers honestly excel here. Now, most laptop speakers we've seen aren't worth kind of anything. In fact, like that Acer Nitro speakers that we talked about, and you can see the review on right here, they were trash. One thing I will say about most gaming speakers, especially at this price point, they're pretty bad. But the MSI shines here, and we were pleasantly surprised by the quality of the audio. Good partnership here, MSI. Way to go. It might be worth looking at this name if you're looking for a future laptop or better laptop speakers, because these are actually pretty good. Now, they're not the best, and they're not like the greatest, but they are certainly usable, and more so than many. Not just myself, but Tom and even Kevin all mentioned how good the speakers are. We would still recommend, of course, a headset for gaming, but for other tasks like going down a YouTube rabbit hole or videos before you go to bed, or maybe just a late night gaming session, then the speakers are absolutely fine. Now, the webcam, however, is kind of a different story. It's only 720p and it has a little bit to be desired. It's rather grainy, which you can see here from the picture that Tom took from using the webcam when he was hanging out here in the studio helping us do this preview. Now, sure, it's passable and definitely usable in a pinch, but if you need something with more quality in like your job or school, you might want to look at like an external cam, such as like the Logitech C920 series. It's like the go-to for everyone. Now, you definitely have more than enough USB ports here on the thin GF63 should you want to add like an additional camera like we talked about, even if you're using a headset, because the connectivity definitely provides that option. Okay, now it's time to set some expectations, because this is not a high-end gaming laptop. This is an entry-level gaming laptop that with a brand new ARC has some growing of its own to get into. Wait. This is running Tomb Raider on high graphical settings at 48 frames per second? Whoa. This is also running Cyberpunk 2077 at basically, what, 30, almost 30 frames per second with ray tracing on low and high graphical settings? Whoa, all of this in like a $900 laptop, and that's all thanks to XeSS and FSR? See, here's the deal. Intel Arc is new, and like any new platform, this is actually gonna like mature, like a wine or a whiskey, or maybe even a boxed wine if you wanna go there. But the point is it will mature, and I do expect performance to get better as like firmware, drivers, and even games start to support it and start to hit their stride with the Intel Arc. But don't count the Intel Arc out, because it's here to compete. And per their presentation, they're all about bringing the cost down for good performance. Now, here is something that you need to know if you indeed are looking at this laptop, and that's about this app called the Intel Graphics Command Center. Much like NVIDIA's GeForce Experience and AMD's Adrenaline software, the Intel Graphics Command Center lets you update drivers, you can scan your computer for new games, and when games are in the Graphics Command Centers, you don't have to worry about going to graphics settings and setting it to discrete Intel Arc GPU in your laptop. If you don't use the Graphics Command Center, then you're gonna have to do this every single time and ensure that the GPU is absolutely being used as the Intel Arc GPU. And I think this will get better as integration get better, but right now I'm just gonna give you a heads up, and it's gonna save you a lot of headache and give you a lot higher frames. Okay, now for the surprise part of this whole video, and that's the benchmark. See, when we started this whole project, like you would with like a $900 laptop, you try to put together like a number of games that you think would run well on a system like this. And the thing is like, to be honest, we just didn't know a ton about the Intel Arc. So we were like, I don't know, but like, what would it be? Like, it is a $900 laptop. And we have been surprised by other laptops on sale at this price, but MSRP being like higher. So like that Acer Nitro we talked about, even though we've seen it on sale for lower than this, the MSRP was much higher. So initially we kicked things off, we were like looking for games that, you know, they were still challenging, but you know, probably most would run without an issue. And we knew could be telling of how this Intel Arc actually performed. So we kicked things off with like World of Warcraft Classic. We got Valorant, Rocket League, and of course, Fortnite. So starting things off with WoW, Wrath of the Lich King Classic on graphics quality 5, we tested taking the boat from Stormwind to Howling Fjord. We saw a solid 151 frames per second, which we were not expecting at all. So that's great. Next up, we tested Valorant at low visual settings, maximizing for frame rate. We saw 157.6 FPS. So next up we did Rocket League. Given the nature of the laptop, it felt like a good fit, and our visual director, Brian, absolutely loves this game. So the high graphical settings, we saw a very solid 104.2 FPS. Finally, like closing the whole thing out, we had to do Fortnite, another game that pretty much runs on anything, but tons of people just want to play. So setting things to low, but also optimizing for competitive settings with like draw distance, etc., we saw things sitting at a very nice and good for tryhards, 121.7 FPS. Now, remember when I talked about laptop only having 8 gigabytes of RAM and how just doubling that and enabling dual channel can have a pretty big impact on performance? Well, how much you might ask? Well, we went and purchased that $48.99. Here it is right here. We got that G-Skill. Here's a $48.99, and there's our Vulcan right there. And so we got this, and you're seeing it from Newegg, this G-Skill Ripjaw 16 gig DDR4 3200 megahertz kit for just shy of $49. So first up, we had World of Warcraft Classic with 16 gigs of RAM instead of 8 gigs. We see it go from 151 frames per second to 190.1 FPS. That is a massive jump, 40 frames for $50. Now, a weird one was Rocket League. We actually saw a decrease in performance, which was actually weird because we went from 104.2 down to 97.4, even though our max FPS and all of the other numbers jumped from like 98.2 to 144. So we're pretty sure there's like a bug here with how it's actually being presented. Now, finally, we had Fortnite, again, starting off with 121.7, but when we added the 16 gigs, we saw that jump up to 171.9 frames. That's right, almost what, just shy of 50 frames. But we weren't done, because when we saw these numbers as high as they were, we were wondering, maybe this isn't as graphically underpowered as we thought. So sticking with 16 gigs of memory, we decided to give Tomb Raider a go and just see what it could do. So we loaded it up and set it to high graphical settings, which we also noticed and were surprised by is that Tomb Raider actually supports XeSS, which if you don't know what that is, that's basically Intel similar technology to Nvidia's DLSS and AMD's FSR. Anyway, we enabled it and we saw Tomb Raider, which you're seeing right here, hit 48 frames per second on highest graphical settings. Okay, Intel Arc, not too bad. So if, I mean, it couldn't, right? I mean, okay. Fine, let's try it. Cyberpunk 2077. I mean, surely it can't handle something as graphically intensive as Cyberpunk. And even if it did, not in any way that's meaningful. I mean, we're not gonna get anywhere near 30 frames per second. But you know what? With a little bit of effort here, Cyberpunk 2077, running at ultra graphics settings with low settings for ray tracing, knocking in at a solid 28 FPS, thanks to FSR on balance. Now, if you turn ray tracing off, or you even, if you want to, you can go to ultra performance, which it looks kind of terrible, but honestly, turning ray tracing off and even playing with some of the other graphical settings, you can get it even better and north of 30 frames per second, which is very, very playable. So I gotta admit, from where we started this journey with this laptop and where we ended, it was a hefty surprise. Not bad for a $50 upgrade and a $900 laptop. So there you have it. The Thin GF63 from MSI, featuring a 12th gen Intel Core i5-12450H and the Intel Arc A370M GPU. Now, I hope and I think we gave you every bit of information you need if you were considering this laptop and enough to be able to make an informed decision on if it's right for you. After spending some good amount of time on this, we're actually considering actually doing a full review in the future, given just how surprised we were on how much this little laptop was able to accomplish. But I would actually love to know what you think, given that this is maybe the first Arc laptop or the first time you've heard of Arc or even seen numbers based on what we've shown. So what did you think of the MSI Thin GF63? Were you surprised as we were by the performance of the Intel Arc A370M? Would you consider a laptop or desktop with an Intel Arc GPU? I would love to know all that and more down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robitech. Did you know we have like a live stream channel for special builds and events? We build like custom PCs and test pre-builds live. So check out Robitech Live down in the description below so you can like and subscribe to know when we go live and don't miss when we do awesome builds like, you know, many of the ones that we already do. Do you have questions about this laptop or other laptops or maybe the Intel Arc or any other tech related questions? Then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/Robitech filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for potential cheap tech or maybe just availability of things like new GPUs or new laptops that are using new GPUs? Then check out @robitech.com or better yet @robitechdeals on Twitter, where we have our guide Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on all things tech, from PC components to TVs to laptops to GPUs, you name it. Now finally, you can follow me and my team on all the other socials @robitech absolutely everywhere. We hope you enjoyed this video and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.